Hey. Pays for horses, keep it in the barn.
You baby boomers and always on your phones.
You baby boomer? Or what are you?
What generation are you? You're old.
Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Directions Idiots. I'm Corbin.
My dad's a baby boomer.
You're basically the same age. And you can follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more juicy content.
How
about those Knight Riders?
Follow us on our personal YouTube channels. Links in the description below. What if, like, when I post this, this is like after they've just lost horribly?
It doesn't change the fact that they've been doing really great.
But it'll be funny. Today we are reacting to a EIC video.
We've reacted to EIC. Easy as 1, 2, 3.
We've reacted to a couple of theirs, I believe.
Yeek.
Do you remember any of them?
No.
Remember the Trump song?
I do.
It was hilarious.
It was very funny.
This one apparently is the Trump and Kim Jong-un song.
It'll be a love song.
It will be a love song. If you'd like to know our personal opinions about the
just follow us on Twitter.
I won't do it here, even though there's been subliminal messages you've seen. But
Your subliminal message, I think, has consistently been...
Anyway, just follow us on Twitter if you'd like to know our personal opinion.
There is juicy content on Twitter. We're not lying, guys.
It's not kid-friendly a lot of times.
Not kid-friendly.
But
it's funny.
The last one was hilarious, so I'm guessing this one
was funny. I remember that one vividly. It was very funny.
I remember you were like so uncomfortable. You're like,
because I didn't know where they were going with it.
Because he's embarrassing.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's a Trump and Kim Jong-un song.
It'll be a love song.
Here we go.
Bring it on.
Press the bell icon and be part of our notification squad.
Be funny if you do this one on November 3rd.
Yes, see.
This song is about two of the most prominent and infamous international politicians in the world right now. They hate each other. We think that they are the best of friends.
What year was this?
So this song is from their point of view.
They've never hated each other.
Oh, they did for a little bit because he called him Rocket Man. Oh.
Just to the length of the song.
Oh, that's so sad. That was so enjoyable. Oh man, that was hilarious.
That was freaking funny.
Okay, so it was 2017. So this was at the time that
he'd been in office a year.
Yeah, he was calling him Rocket Man, and
yeah, then, before and then, he went and visited him, and they French kissed.
Yeah,
and then it was
when they met and like
had a love fest,
docked each other, and
yeah, well, showed each other their missiles.
Do you know what docking is?
The legit correspondence between them. One of the correspondences that he wrote to Trump.
I know. We're not going to get into that. If you'd like to follow us on Twitter, you can.
Great.
That was hilarious.
Because it was all true.
Yeah, and it's just great to put it on the Friends theme song.
Yes.
That was a Friends
really theme. Good. Right. Yes, that was Friends. I know you're not a big fan, but come on.
Was that song... That song only got popular because of the show, correct?
It's the theme song written for Friends.
It was written for
written
Friends.
For the show.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my understanding. If I'm wrong, then I blew it. I thought that was...
Who's the band?
Who's the band?
Yeah, that they sang this song.
Don't know. No, but just like any, but that's one of the biggest songs, like a theme song that became an actual like standalone song. Whereas, you know, like everybody making your way in the world today takes everything you got. That never was like gotten airplay on the radio.
Yeah.
That did. I got a lot of airplay on the radio.
Yeah.
When the show first came out. But yeah, it's a great song. Great parody. Really good lyrics.
They're hilarious. I would
love... Really funny.
I would love to see more. Because every... Both, I think we've seen... Because we saw a Trump song, obviously this one. And then I think we've seen something else.
I like this one even more. This one was...
The Trump one was hilarious.
I'm not taking anything away from that one. That one was funny. I really liked this one a lot.
Oh, the States of India. I remember we did that one. That was one of their videos, remember?
Wow. A while ago. Almost a year ago, right?
8 months ago, yeah.
Yeah. Lexi, we need those guys to come back. I miss them so much.
You see them all the time.
I know. And there's been some times I've said, hey, we're filming at such and such, and they were going to do it, and they didn't. And
oh, God.
They just hate you.
They apparently have a Modi song.
Oh, God. You're not going to...
I bet that went over well.
That probably went over... How many views?
2 million? 12 million?
Yeah.
Wow, that's funny. I bet people loved that one. Anyways,
I don't even want to. I actually do want to know. I'd like to read the comment thread. 12 million views. There's probably 2 million comments.
I'm excited they do a bunch of fun songs like that, though. They got the Goa song,
The Freedom to Disagree, Outrage Live.
Okay, cool. Well, I'd love to see more from them because. Both videos that we're, all three videos that we've seen of theirs have been absolutely hilarious. And so we like to laugh, especially at Donald Trump's expense.
Yep.
So let us know more videos down below, and also follow us on Twitter if you've, or not. If, yeah. Whatever.
Took my letter.